We told you about this story Friday. A utility pole snapped. The transformer came tumbling down and destroyed a car parked in a driveway in Algiers.
Now, it sounds and looks like a rare event, but one state lawmaker is afraid that this faulty pole exposes a bigger problem.
He's afraid that our state is a storm away from serious utility pole failures, and unless something is done quickly, residents across Louisiana could find themselves fighting insurance and utility companies.
WDSU News reporter Rosa Flores has been digging into this story for weeks now, and she has another story you will see only on 6.
All it takes is a glance down a straight street to notice some things in New Orleans are crooked. I'm talking about utility poles that are leaning in just about every direction. Terry Wade has one in front of her house.
We was playing Russian roulette.
It snapped, destroyed her car, and triggered a huge blame game. Entergy owned the transformer, AT&T owned the pole, but she ended up calling her insurance company to get attention.
What if our life was lost? Then what would you say? Call insurance people? No one. Entergy, BellSouth, no one came forward to say, Ms. Wade, we're sorry. What can we do to help you?
Wade eventually received the fair market value for her car. And after WDSU got involved, AT&T even offered her an extra $2,500. But State Representative Ricky Template will tell you, she's probably not the only one with a dangerous pole in her front yard.
One of the problems, and we experience it with a major storm like Katrina, where poles that failed wasn't necessarily just failing because of the windstorm. They were failing because they were compromised, be it from being old age or by termite damage.
His phone has been ringing since the storm. Calls from constituents concerned about who to go to when a utility pole appears unsafe. He looked into it and was shocked to find out utility pole safety is not regulated, not at the national level, not at the state level, not at the local level.
We don't have a standard in the state of Louisiana for our utility companies to follow.
That's why he wrote two concurrent resolutions during last year's legislature. They're filed with the Louisiana Secretary of State. One of them urges utility companies to create a statewide utility pole reporting system. The other one asks them to adopt the National Electrical Safety Code. Here's the catch. A concurrent resolution is adopted by both houses, but it's not law.
And according to the constitution of this state, lawmakers can't write laws to regulate utility companies. The Public Service Commission is in charge. We asked. And when it comes to utility poles, the commission holds companies to a good faith standard.
Until someone's accountable and has a responsibility, there's always going to be there's a question out there, who is responsible? Or some people are just in limbo because they don't know where to turn.
Which means, for now, residents with crooked utility poles can expect everything but straight answers.
Now, I asked the Public Service Commission, Entergy, and AT&T about these two concurrent resolutions that would create a statewide utility pole reporting system. The Public Service Commission says it's aware of those resolutions. Both AT&T and Entergy said they were members of the National Joint Utilities Notification System, a database that is shared by all utility companies but is not available to the public. You see, I asked both companies two things: how many poles they own in the state of Louisiana and how often they inspect those poles. Neither company answered my question. So while State Representative Ricky Template keeps pushing for a statewide registry, what should you do to make sure you're protected? I'll let you know what state and national experts say when I see you in about 30 minutes. Live on your side, I'm Rosa Flores for WDSU News.
Thank you, Rosa. And under the concurrent resolutions that were filed with the Louisiana Secretary of State, lawmakers also asked the Public Service Commission to complete a feasible study.
The report is due during the 2011 legislative session, actually.